While addressing the press at Parliament after chairing the opposition shadow cabinet, the leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, noted that the decision to boycott the State of the Nation address was premised on the fact that opposition doesn't find it relevant to subject MPs' attendance to COVID-19 testing. The opposition, which has 108 legislators in the House, claimed that COVID testing on presidential events is another conduit to wastage of public funds as it costs the government an estimate of $3 billion to test people that attend an event.
Our people in the opposition, that one, we must be leading in stopping genome survey from abusing taxpayers' money over these tests and encourage them to stay away from both tests of the national address and the budget speech. After all, we passed the budget. There's no reason why the taxpayer should lose money out of a ritual that genome survey is going to perform. At least the opposition should lead by telling Genome 7 that this money is being wasted, on top of the other complaints we have against him, including abusing the rights of citizens.
As they express concerns on funds lost on COVID testing, the opposition also queries the costs spent on COVID testing. They also question procedures through which companies which administer COVID tests are contracted.
The taxpayer already falling on hard times could have this money saved for more serious activities. Now that we also know that the budget is hugely constrained and less is left to the benefit of the taxpayer. And we want to support, to propose to General Museveni and his family to take booster doses. If they are the only vulnerable Ugandans, we encourage them to take booster doses to really enhance their immunity.
The opposition contends that COVID testing is an abuse since the World Health Organization declared an end to COVID-19 as a global health emergency. Mpuuga says the boycott will also apply to the national budget speech event slated for next week at Kololo.
As a taxpayer on a single day coughs anywhere between 3 to 5 billion in these tests, we believe that it's the West. You have State of the Nation today, and you have the budget on Wednesday next week.
Report compiled by Fred Kajibi for the news.